What's going on, Facebook? You know we got to get our praise on first. We're listening to Little Drummer Boy by Anthony Hamilton. Yes. Share this with someone. It's the Christmas season and we celebrating the reason for the season. Yes. Come on now. Yes. Yes. Come on in. What's going on, Instagram? Good afternoon, Facebook. Yes. I love this song by Anthony Hamilton. Hey, Lord, what's going on? Anthony Hamilton is singing this song. King of all kings. Little Drummer Boy. It's on Anthony Hamilton Christmas CD. If you don't have his Christmas CD, I suggest you get it. Yes. Good afternoon. Good afternoon. What's going on, Facebook? What's going on, Instagram? Welcome, welcome, welcome to Tuesday. This is Testimony Tuesday. You know how we do. I come on and I give you a Holy Spirit-led word amongst other things. But before I get into all of that, we were listening to Little Drummer Boy by Anthony Hamilton. He has a really nice Christmas CD. So if you're looking for some Christmas music, I recommend the CD. I want you to share with your page, your friends, your acquaintances, share with them to let them know that Testimony Tuesday is live and that we're about to hear a word from the Holy Spirit. I am Anita J. Merchant. For those of you who don't know me, I am known as the prayer advocate. I am sold out to prayer. And what I mean by that is I know prayer is the substance of everything, especially in my life. But I want to encourage you to have an opportunity to make prayer the substance of your life. Prayer changes things. Prayer is our number one way we communicate with God. Prayer is the substance of the air that we breathe. And so I want to encourage you, if you don't have a prayer life, I am a prayer coach. And what I do is I help encourage, I help teach, I help you maintain and establish a consistent prayer life, put a prayer life in place for your day-to-day living. No matter what your occupation is, no matter what you do from day to day, no matter what life is bringing you and giving you, you need to have a consistent prayer life. Hey, my sister June, you need to make sure that your prayer life is tight, that it is the first thing that you take care of in the course of your day, not later on at night, not just during the day when you need something from the Lord, but have a consistent prayer life. If you're interested in working with me, you can DM me or you can email me at visualsofprayer@gmail.com. I'm going to say that again. visualsofprayer@gmail.com. So, you know, here on Testimony Tuesday, we do a few things before we get to the Holy Spirit-led word. And so today, we're doing our shirt of today, which is the shirt of Testimony Tuesday for this week. It says, "Woman, thou art loose. Woman, thou art loose." Now, I purchased this many, many years ago when I went to the Woman, Thou Loose conference. You know, that is sponsored and put on by the Potter's House under Bishop T.D. Jakes and his wife, Sarita Jakes. And I purchased this shirt, but I always, every now and then, I'll pull this shirt back out to remind me of how far God has brought me. So, woman, thou art loose. I want to give a shout out today. You know, I give a shout out to a Black African-American business, not shading other businesses, but that's just what the Holy Spirit has led me to do on Testimony Tuesday. And today I want to give a shout out to a gentleman who has a boutique, a little shop down in New Orleans, Louisiana. You know, that's my second heart from my old, original heart of Alexandria. But New Orleans is my second home. And so I was there this past weekend with some women who we share the same about our beliefs in God and how we know how God is the substance of our lives. So you got to surround yourself by women who believe in our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who will hold you accountable, but will also pray with you, talk with you, or whatever you need. And so I had a wonderful weekend with a group of ladies where we did a day trip to New Orleans. And while we were there, we all stopped at this gentleman's cart down in the area where, you know, you can go to the little flea market and buy items from people who are down there. But this gentleman stood out. His name is Oscar. And he does earrings, he does necklaces, he does brooches, he does all kind of things. But it's called Oscar of New Orleans. Check him out. Look at his boutique or his cart when you go down to New Orleans. As a matter of fact, I bought these earrings. Aren't they gorgeous from Oscar? Aren't they gorgeous? Aren't they unbelievable? And I bought this cross brooch from Oscar. He does a wonderful job with his hands. The jewelry is one of a kind. I bought another pair with him. You'll eventually see me wear them. But I want to thank Oscar. Was very personable. He took pictures with the women that wanted to take pictures. He was real comical. He was just a joyous to be around. And so we enjoyed and supported Oscar of New Orleans. So if you're in the New Orleans area, and he also has a website. So if you're in the New Orleans area or you need to reach him, you can go to Oscar's website, which is Oscar's www.oscarupright.com to purchase his jewelry or either to just contact him when you are down in the New Orleans area. Go seek him out and support his cart. He has a lot of beautiful, colorful jewelry. I don't know about you, but I like colors because colors bring about life and vibrancy. And so these earrings are a pair that I purchased from Oscar along with this cross. So I want to send a shout out to Oscar down there in New Orleans, Louisiana, and to thank him for his personable experience we had with him. Now, today's testimony is this. I have been cleaning out closets. I have been getting rid of things that I haven't used in years. I have been just clearing space and clearing space because God has shown me I am holding up some blessings that He has with me. Not so much as materialistic things, but I'm holding up my blessings because I'm holding on to stuff that I did not use last year. I'm not using this year, hadn't used in the years before. And remember, I talked about this in a earlier in the month about cleaning out a space where you can have some space in your home where you and Jesus meet every day. Have a special place, whether it's a corner, it's a closet, it's part of the living room, part of the dining room, even your kitchen island. But have a space. So anyway, I have been cleaning out things and getting rid of things that I have was holding on to for no specific reason. Clothes, materialistic things, items, you name it. And so on yesterday when I was leaving Pilates, I had already loaded up my car of the things that I was going to give to Goodwill. And so as I was driving to go to Goodwill, the Holy Spirit spoke to me and said, I want you to bless the guy, the gentleman that helps unload the things out of the back of your car at the Goodwill place. And I'm like, well, Lord, and I always keep books, little gift bags, to just give gifts to people when I see them or when the Holy Spirit leads me to give someone something who just may be going through something and I don't know and no one else know. But anyway, so as I proceeded to go to the Goodwill to drop off the bags of items and the boxes of stuff that I had, I said, okay, Lord, you want me to give the guy who unloads, you know, sometimes the gentlemen will come out and unload the stuff if you're a female, if they see you have a lot of things and that they're heavy. Now, this is going to bless somebody. Because if you're in tune with the Holy Spirit, it will not mislead you. It's going to order your steps every step of the way. And so I'm real big on listening to the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is what He is, what helps us to know what God is wanting us to do on a day-to-day basis, minute by minute, hour by hour, whatever you want to call it. And so as I was driving to the Goodwill, and Holy Spirit was like, I want you to bless the guy, the gentleman that helps you unload the items out of your car. And so my mind started going, oh, okay, so I have some little gift bags. I have a gift bag. I have a few books in the back of my car where I always keep those things. I said, oh, I can put a book about prayer in a little cute Christmas gift bag and bless this brother with a financial blessing. See, God was specific. The Holy Spirit told me all along, it's going to be a financial blessing. And I'm saying to myself, okay, Lord. See, God will provide and give you what you need when He tells you to bless someone. So bear with me. And as I was going along driving, I was like, okay, Holy Spirit, what financial blessing do you want me to give? How much? What do you want me to say when I get there? Just guide me, Holy Spirit. That's all I said. So I drove, and when I got to the Goodwill, I backed my Jeep into the spot where you deliver the items. The gentleman comes to the door and he was like, oh no, ma'am, I got it. I can get it. I can help you. I can take care of it. I said, well, thank you. He says, how's life going? I said, great. He says, well, this is pretty good. I won't complain, right? And so I said, okay. So as he was unloading the things, I went around to the backside of my car, got the little Christmas gift bag because I bought like about 12 of them in a pack. And I keep them in my car. Got the gift bag, and I had about four or five different books about prayer. So I just pulled one, put that in the bag, went to my wallet, got out a financial blessing for him, stuck that inside of the book. As he was finishing to unload my items, I said, are you ready for Christmas? Are you celebrating Christmas? And he said, yeah, you know what, ma'am? I'm not going to complain. It could be a whole lot worse. I'm not going to complain. So I was like, okay. So as he was turning to leave, I said, wait, I have something for you. So I handed him the bag. And in the bag was the prayer book and the financial blessing. And so I proceed to go to my car, told him, have a blessed holiday. Just be reminded that Jesus loves him. And he said, thank you, ma'am. That really made my day. So as I was getting ready to pull off, he comes running out of the door. He has the bag in his hand. He pulls the book out and he sees the financial blessing. And he says, ma'am, you are not going to believe this. And I said, what? He said, I was just saying, God, I need a little bit more money to buy my kids at least one gift. Come on, Holy Spirit. He said, I just needed a little bit more money. I didn't tell him how much. I didn't tell him how and when to do. He said, but I'm starting to believe in God. And so I just, like, let me test this God that everybody is talking about. Let me test this God that says he will supply all my needs. And he started going and talking about God. I listened to him. He said, you had no idea. Come on, Holy Spirit. You had no idea what I had prayed to God. I said, well, for me, prayer is everything. And he said, this book that you blessed me with, ma'am, I really needed this book to explain to me about prayer. Why do we pray? What's the purpose of prayer? He said, this gift right here that you gave me, he said, I'm not even talking about the money, but the money is blessing me. He said, because I can go buy my daughter a Barbie doll that she wants and my son a truck. Come on, Holy Spirit. He said, you didn't even know how when you pulled up, he said, it was just something about you that made me run out and say, oh, no, ma'am, don't get the items. I got them. And he did. And he said, ma'am, I just want to thank you that I know that God is real just by what you did. He said, it ain't so much about the money. He said, but this prayer book that you gave me, you did not know I was struggling with a prayer life. You did not know. I didn't even know what to do with my prayer life. So see, I'm sharing this testimony because you've got to be in tune with the Holy Spirit to know when to do what God has called you to do. And how do you know what the Holy Spirit is saying when it's speaking to you, when it's telling you things? It's your prayer time, your relationship with God. You hear his voice and then you move. You hear his voice, he will order your steps. And so the brother began, I said, well, you know what? I said, let me pray with you. He says, oh, yes, ma'am, I received it. So I prayed with the brother. And after praying with him, I said, you be reminded that God does love you. And so when I drove off, I began to cry a little bit because I said, Lord, I had no idea why you were sending me the way you were sending me. But because of hearing your voice, I thanked him for knowing his voice. I thanked him for understanding the purpose and the reason of the Holy Spirit. I just began to thank him and worship him. It wasn't for what he allowed me to do because he blesses me all the time to bless someone else. I don't hold on to the blessings when he says, release this and give this. And so I'm saying this to someone who's going to hear this or share this with someone who needs to hear this. You need to make sure you have a constant prayer life with God. You need to make sure you remain in his presence throughout the day so you can hear him order your steps. You need a consistent prayer life. I'm just going to leave it at that. But God, he's an awesome God. He blessed me to bless someone else, and that made my whole day yesterday. I was so happy to hear when he said, I can buy my daughter a Barbie doll and my son a truck. Praise the Lord. Thank God for the Holy Spirit. And so today's Holy Spirit-led word leads into my shirt that I have on, Woman, Thou Art Loose. You need to remember this if you remember nothing else, the value of you as a woman, especially in the eyes of God. You need to understand how valuable you are as a woman. Not that men are not valuable, they are. But this is for my sisters out there, my praying women, my confused women, my women who just don't know which way to turn. You need to be reminded that the value you bring to the world, the value of your life, the value of God creating you, was a value that no one else can give you. So you value my sisters, my friends, my acquaintances, all the women over the world. You are of value. And so I'm Holy Spirit word led is for the women. Brothers, I'm not excluding you, but you'll probably get something out of this because this can pertain to you too. But today's Holy Spirit word led is to my sisters, those who feel like their backs up against the wall, those who feel like they just can't go on. Those who feel like they are so overwhelmed and heavy burden, especially during this time of the year. We as women, we're the caregivers, so we want to try to make sure everybody gets what they want. We want to make sure everybody is happy. We want to make sure that everybody knows that they are loved. We do this because that's part of our makeup. But today, I want to share with you, my sisters, and say to you, what's disturbing your peace? I'm going to say this one more time. What's disturbing your peace? Woman, Thou Art Loosed helps you with your peace. Now, you're probably wondering why. Well, what does that have to do with anything? What does that mean? Well, peace itself alone, it means calm, serenity, a feeling that everything is going to be okay. It's something that we just walk around and we feel good when we're at peace. But right now, I want you to take a few minutes and just slow down and just ask yourself, what is disturbing your peace? There's nothing like having peace. There's nothing like being in a peaceful moment or a peaceful mode or a peaceful place. But we as women, sometimes we take on so much, our peace is disturbed. We are not at peace with our family. We're not at peace with our marriage. We're not at peace with our children. We're not at peace on the job. We're just not at peace. And it's because we as women, we take on so much of the world, of other people's problems, of family problems, issues, whatever. But we want to change that because, see, the devil, he gets a thrill and a joy out of this. He gets a thrill out of when you are not at peace, when you all worked up, when you stressed out, when you don't just understand what's going on. He loves to see that. But when you're at peace, your life is totally different. When you're not at peace, it can affect your health. When you're not at peace, with things like this is what we get worked up about and we're not at peace about. Rebellious children, we don't be at peace with that. Our spouse, our marriage is rocky. We're not at peace with that. Lack of money. You know, women, we tend to worry about the money. We worry about the money. So that disturbs our peace. A bitter sibling, someone you're not getting along with in your family, but you love them. That disturbs our peace. There are so many things that we allowed as women to disturb our peace. But I'm here to say this to you. Don't allow the devil to get the victory over your peace. Don't allow the devil to take what you are worrying about, what you are concerned about, what you lose sleep over, where you walk on the floor, where you just don't understand. We have to allow the devil to be put on notice as of today that he will no longer disturb our peace. He will no longer have us worked up, stressed out, where we got to take blood pressure medication. We will no longer allow him to take us to the point to where we are trying to drink ourselves to peace, where we may go do those shopping sprees, can't afford them, charge up the credit cards and stress us out later on in the year. We have to determine that our peace comes from God. Our peace comes from God. I'm going to say this one more time. Our peace comes from God. Examine your life. Take some time from this busy week, because this week is the busiest week of the year. Take some time from this busy week and ask yourself, get your piece of pencil and a journal, whatever. What is disturbing my peace? What is causing me to lose sleep at night? Who do I need to remove out of my life so that I can have my peace? Who or which one of my children I need to just totally turn over to God? Quit picking it back up. Quit picking it back up. Who in my life or what circumstance or situation I have no control over that I need to change by removing it out of my life, by letting it go and totally giving it to God? You know, we say this and we speak with our mouths. I'm just going to turn it over to the Lord. But do we really turn it over to him? Because if you're still losing sleepless nights and you're still stressed out, you haven't turned it totally over to him. Because once you turn it totally over to him, peace comes on us. Peace, like his words say, peace that passes all understanding. We don't have to know the whys and the hows and the whens. We just got to trust him. And we just got to tell him, Lord, take the wheel. Lord, take this off of me. My cup is bearing down. I am heavy burden. Lift this up off of me, Lord. I am giving that child to you. I'm giving those finances to you. I'm going to stop getting drunk. I'm going to stop smoking weed. I'm going to stop doing drugs. I'm going to stop charging up credit cards, doing unnecessary shopping. I'm guilty of that many, many years ago. When I got stressed, I went shopping. Didn't need it. But I went. I didn't need the clothes I bought, but I went. And it was all along God was saying, you're not trusting me, Anita. You're saying you're the private. You say you believe in prayer, but your actions is not backing up what your mouth is saying. So see, we got to get to where we line up our actions with our mouth. If we are turning it totally over to God, like we say we are, we have to let it go. If it's a child that's wavering, going in a different direction from what you taught him or her, you got to let them go and let God totally take over. See, we can't bear our children's crosses. Come on, Holy Spirit. We can't wear their cross. They have to wear their own cross and bear their own cross. What God has ordained and held us accountable for doing, once you get them grown, you got to let them go. It's not easy. But I promise you, when you totally let it go, you're going to have that peace that passes our understanding. You're going to be able to sleep at night. You won't go off on a drunk binge and get drunk. You won't be getting high. You won't be using drugs. You won't be going into stores buying unnecessary things when you have totally, come on, Holy Spirit, let it go and given it to Jesus. I have two scriptures, you know. I always like to back up what the Holy Spirit has led me to just speak about briefly. And these two scriptures, I want you to meditate on them when you are stressed, when you worried, when you're over concerned about that adult child. Because see, we as women, oh Lord, Holy Spirit, we have a hard time letting go of our adult children. We don't want them to make the same mistakes that we made. But you have to remember, the God that we serve is going to allow them to bear their cross. No matter what you do, you can't buy them from bearing their cross. You can't keep them from bearing their cross. You got to totally give it over to church. And the Holy Spirit keeps sending me back, because there's some women who's going to listen to this, or who's listening right now, where God has told you, let that child go, give him back to me, and let me to allow them how to walk their path, to let them bear their cross. There's some people on here who's going to hear this later on, who's worried about their money. God is going to tell you, he says through the Holy Spirit, I got this. Your necessities, the things that you really need, I'm going to provide. That's what my words say. Now, we know we go running off and trying to get the most expensive handbag to impress somebody, the most expensive toy to impress the child. Child may play with it and not. Like, I don't know, with my grandchild, she want things from the dollar store more than she want things from the toy store. So, see, we got to get out of that trying to do it in our own strength, trying to make that decision or put that person or that place into the position we want them to, and allow God to do it. My two scriptures for today. One is John 14 and 27. John 14 and 27. I'm reading out of the NIV version, and this is what the word says. John 14 and 27. It says this. Where is John 14 and 27? I'm sorry, you guys. Okay. Whoever has my commands and keeps them, and the one who loves me, the one who loves me will be loved by my Father. And hold up. Nope, that's the wrong verse. I'm sorry, y'all. These contacts is acting up. 14 in 27. Okay, here we go. All right. It says this. Where is the scripture? Y'all forgive me now, because I thought I highlighted it. I'm sorry. Here it is. I'm sorry. 14 to 27. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not be afraid. See, we can't rely on the world for peace. We got to rely on God. He says in his word that we're going to have trials and tribulations, but he also comes back and says, if we rely on him, that we will have peace. And the other scripture is John 16 and 33. And here is what it says. I have told you these things so that in me you may have peace. In this world you will have trouble, but take heart, I have overcome the world. So see, he's telling us, we're going to have these trials, our peace going to be disturbed. But what do you do with it when it starts to happen. What do you say when it starts to happen? You open up your mouth, you declare, and you decree, I'm going to have peace about this, Lord. I'm turning this over to you, Lord. I'm giving this to you, Lord. You can have this, Lord. It's just too much for me to bear. I want my peace back, Lord. I want to sleep at night, Lord. I want to be able to walk through my home in peace without confusion and commotions and all other things. I want to be able to have a relationship with my sibling or my child. Lord, I just need peace. Let's pray about peace. Father God, we come to you today. Lord, we just say thank you. Father, thank you for your word that reminds us about peace. Lord, we thank you for being Lord of Lords, Kings of Kings, our Heavenly Father, our Father of all things, for you have been the creator of each and every one of us. Father, we thank you as women, as a woman, how you have made us, how you have orchestrated our lives, how you use us, Lord God. We say thank you, Father. Lord, we ask you right now in the name of Jesus, if there's someone that can hear the sound of my voice, that you allow them to take back their peace. That you allow them to come to you and lay that heavy burden at your feet. That you allow them to come to you and just turn it over to you. Just hand it to you as if your hands are holding and waiting to receive whatever it is, Lord, that's disturbing their peace, Father. Lord, we need peace like never before. There's so much going on in the world, but you said you have overcome the world. And so we're trusting and believing you that our peace will be better than it was before, that our peace will come upon us, Lord. Let it come from us, Lord God, to other women. Let us be able to speak and open up our mouths into other women to bring them about peace, Lord. Lord, cover us with peace from the crown of our heads to the sole of our feet. Lord, let us speak peace into our fellow sister, into our mother, our brother, our sister, our children. Let us just speak about peace this time. Lord, let us have a peaceful week. Let us have a peaceful holiday. Let us be at peace with no matter what the circumstance is. We're going to just turn it over to you today, Lord God. Father, let us not get caught up in things that would disturb our peace. If it's a person, Lord God, help us to remove them that's disturbing our peace. If it's a place or a situation, help us to remove that out of our life. Lord, if it's finances, let us be reminded to come to you with every penny that you've blessed us with to know how to spend, how to save, and what to do with. Let us hear the Holy Spirit tell us, no, don't go do this. No, you don't need this. Father, we just ask you in the name of Jesus that you continue to let your peace roam boldly over the land, over the earth, Lord God. Wherever confusion, wherever disruption is going on, we ask you to bring about peace. And Father, we're thanking you today for the peace that you're going to give us. Peace that we will never forget that you've given us this day, Lord God. Peace that we will hold on to remind us who you are and what you're capable of doing. And your word to remind us about the peace that we receive from you. We love you today, Lord God. We bless you. We praise you. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen, and amen. I hope this word has blessed you today. I want you to leave this broadcast reminding yourself that peace is something you need. And the only place you get your peace from is from God. Be reminded of this. Let nothing good or bad interrupt your consistent prayer life. Have a happy holiday, a blessed Christmas, and be reminded Jesus is the reason for the season. Bless you. Yes. Hey, my cousin Brenda. Hey, Cece. Peace. Type in there, peace. Yes.
I have no gifts to bring.
Yes. Okay, Brenda. Okay. Peace. Come on, type in that peace. Yes. 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 Happy holidays. I'm excited. My birthday is Christmas Day. Come on, Anthony. Yes. You all have a blessed day.